In this problem, we are given the following circuit diagram. We need to use the mesh current method and find the power absorbed or delivered by the 60 ohm and the 80 ohm resistors. To start this out, we should note that this is part of Kirchhoff's voltage law, or we can use Kirchhoff's voltage law to do this. We are going to break each of these into their own closed circuits. So when we look at these, we're looking at it in three parts like this. We're going to look at this part, and then this part individually, but also together at the same time. So to start this off, I'm going to look at the voltages that we have in here, and I'm going to draw their direction. They're going this way and this way. Now I'm going to draw the currents flowing through each of these parts. It does not matter which way you draw the currents, it just matters that you stay consistent. I'm drawing them this way, but it should work the same if we were to actually flip our currents. However, our equations, all of the equations that I will be doing will be backwards, but the answers should be the same should you choose to do it the other way. So looking at this, we're going to start and solve for this first part. We have 128 volts. This is going in the opposite direction as our current. So we'll have our 128 volts, but it's going to be a negative 128 volts. Now we are going to look at our resistors, and since they're in series within this part of our equation, we're going to add them together. So we're going to have plus 60 ohms, and this is for I1. Now our I1 right here is also next to our I2. So we have to have a minus 60 ohms, and this is for our I2. We don't have an I3, because remember, each of these are a different current. This is the current flowing for here, this is the current flowing through here, and this is the current flowing through here, and we're calling them I1, I2, and I3. It doesn't touch I3, but just for consistency, we'll add a 0 I3 and set this equal to 0. I'm going to move this around so it's a little bit easier to see, and also simplify some things. So when I do that, I'm going to get this equation right here. Next, we're going to look at our I2, which I will do in red. So we don't have any voltages here, we just have the resistors. We're going to add them all together, and we're going to get a 144 ohm resistor. This is for I2. It's right next to our I1, so we're going to have to subtract that part. We'll do a negative 60 ohms, and this is for I1. It's also next to our I3 part, which is our 80 ohm resistor. So we'll have to do a minus 80 ohms, and this is I3. That's it, and we're setting this equal to 0. Again, the reason why we're subtracting this is because when we look at the current for our I2, it's flowing down this way. When we look at the current for our I3, it's flowing up this way. Since they're an opposite, we know that there has to be a negative. Now I'm going to simplify this just like we did for the first one, and that is our equation. Now we're going to solve for the last one. We have a voltage here, however it's going in the same direction as our current, so instead of a negative we're going to have a positive 320 volts. We're going to add the current flowing through our I3, so this is going to be our I3 times the actual resistors, my bad. It's going to be 90 ohms because we're just adding all of the resistors that are in series for this particular circuit, times I3. Minus the part that's for our I2, which is the 80 ohm resistor exactly, and this is for our I2, set equal to 0. Now I'm just going to simplify this a little bit. These are our three formulas. Now I'm going to write it so it looks kind of like a matrix. We have all of these. We have our I1s listed on one part. We have our I2s listed in the next part. I3s listed in the next part, and then we have everything on the right side listed here. To put this in a matrix, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make this a little bit simpler. I'm going to make our I1s a X, I'll make our I2s equivalent to a Y, and our I3s equivalent to a Z. I'm going to use symbollab.com to use their matrix solver. So after I plug in all of our values here, just as I had them in the OneNote, and scroll down, we can see that we're going to get this X, Y, and Z for our values. If we bring that over in here, we can reassign these. We know that this is actually our I1, this is our Z, so this is going to be our I3, and this is our Y, so this is our I2. Now we are going to solve for power, since we know all the resistors for each of these parts, and we know the current flowing through all of these parts, which we need. So there's a couple different formulas for power. The two that I think we are going to use is that power is equal to voltage times current, and that power is equal to current squared times resistance. So we're first going to solve for the power of the 60 ohm resistor. We can say P 60 ohms is equal to, and for the 60 ohm resistor, we know the resistance and we know the current, but we don't know the voltage. So we're going to be using this formula. We have I squared times resistance. We know our resistance to be 60 ohms because that is given. And our I for this 60 ohm resistor is kind of two-parters. It is the current flowing through for this IB right here, but we don't really need the IA, IB, IC, ID, and IE. It's generous that they give it to us, but we don't really need it for this. What we can do is say that our I1 is flowing in this direction. So we are going to have our I1, which we know to be negative 34 over 5, because our I2 is flowing in this way, and since they're flowing in opposite ways, there has to be a subtraction, minus the I2, which we know to be a negative 19 over 2, and this is squared. And this is going to give us the answer that power of 60 ohms is equal to 437.4 watts. So this is the power for this first part. Now we're going to solve the power for our 80 ohm resistor. Looking at our 80 ohm resistor, it's going to be quite the same. So we're going to use power is equal to our current squared times resistance, and we know our resistance to be 80 ohms. So we're just going to have 80 here. And then for our I, we can see that our I2 is going down this way, and our I3 is going this way. So we're going to have a plus I2. We're going to have negative 19 over 2 minus the I3, which is a negative 12. So we'll have this in here, and this is squared. If we do this, we are going to get that our power is equal to 500 watts. So these are the two answers for this question and how to do this problem. If you want more problems like this, there'll be a playlist linked below, as well as the notes that I use to study for this chapter and help study for other homework problems and exams.